हेलो, हाय हाय ऑल ऑफ यू. हाय विजय, हाय वैभवी. हेलो ऑल, सो नाइस टू सी यू ऑल हियर. हाय आयुषी, हाय कुंश, हाउ आर यू ऑल. हेलो चिन्मय, आई होप यू हैव जस्ट डाउनलोड द पिक्टो ब्लॉक्स एंड हैव डन अ गुड प्रैक्टिस ओवर देयर. The things that we have learned in the last class about the programming, the Toby walking, it seems to be a very exciting project for you. So I hope that everyone has done that task. Hello, it's a very pleasure to see all of you here. Hi, Pratik. हेलो सत्यम,
हेलो, वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल द टीचर्स, पेरेंट्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव जॉइंड. वी विल बी जस्ट स्टार्टिंग इन 2 to 3 मिनट्स. वी आर जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर अदर जॉइनर्स टू जॉइन द सेशन. ओके, so if you are I'll just share you a link. Okay, if the students who were not present yesterday, they don't have to worry, we have recorded the session for you and I will just share the recording with you guys. Okay, so students who have missed the yesterday session, they can take down the link and after the session you can go through with the day one, not a problem. Okay, we will be sharing you the links, don't worry.
All the important content will going to be shared to you, so don't worry at all. But yes, but just do a lot of practice and enjoy the session.
Okay, so sir, can you tell me about the competition? So we will be telling you about the competition towards the end of the session also. Okay, but for as of now, if you have asked this question, so as you know, this is a 3-day webinar series and you have to submit one project on the link which we will be sharing. So basically you have to make a video of your project and submit that video, upload that video to the YouTube, and you have to share the link with us on the form which we will be sharing to you, and the winners will be getting an exciting AI robotic kits. And the detail of the competitions we will be telling you towards the end. I again welcome all the students, teachers, and parents who have joined us on the day 2 of a Scratch Week celebration with PictoBlocks. We will be starting the session in 2 minutes.
Prina, we are going to learn about an artificial intelligence today. All the things related to the video about the competitions will going to be told to you after the session, right? At the end, we are going to tell you, or yeah. And based on that, you need to make your wonderful projects, right? In depth about the idea we are going to tell you at the end. So as we have in the yesterday's part, we have learned about the programming. Yes. If you have practices, then it's a good thing. If not, then please download the PictoBlocks and practice it. And today we are going to learn about an artificial intelligence.
Yeah, students, if you are doing those things in your smartphone or in your laptop, you can do a screen recording, explain the project and submit, upload the video to the YouTube and submit us the video link in the form which we will be sharing to you. So I think we are good to start, Shalin. Shall we start?
Yes, definitely. Again, I welcome all of you to the day of a Scratch Week celebration with the PictoBlocks. So let's start to learn about artificial intelligence. I'm sharing my screen with you now. So is my screen is visible to all of you?
Yes, Shalin.
Okay. So let's start. So introduction to AI. So what is an AI? Don't worry. AI is basically an artificial intelligence only. Yeah. So examples of AI, like you have just seen multiple example of AI around you. Like we have just surrounded with an application of AI only. Right, a very well-known example that you have listened or heard is basically about Alexa. What is that Alexa? It is basically a smart speaker. What does that speaker do? Yeah, so what do you do with the speaker? Like, we are going to say something and Alexa will going to respond. Like it is going to just respond like a human do, right? So the image you can see, like a person is asking, go meet an Alexa. The Alexa is saying, no one is expected in San Francisco. So what is here? Asking the question and Alexa is giving.
Yes, yeah, students, I think due to some network error, Shalin sir just got disconnected, but not a problem. Let me just check. So basically, I'll take the few points actually what Shalin was telling you about. So basically, Shalin was telling you about what exactly artificial intelligence is, right? So yeah, as said by Shalin, that yeah, we are surrounded with so many devices which uses an artificial intelligence. Definitely, these words are little sort of, I should say, we sometimes fear what exactly is artificial intelligence, what a big word it is, right? But to be very honest, it's going to be very, very easy for you to understand these things. We will be describing you in such a manner that it will become so easy that you are going to be, you will be a programmer in artificial intelligence. So yeah, we will be sharing you the yesterday's link, Sunidhi, in few moments, okay? First, try to focus what today we are teaching you, because we will be sharing you the links as of now, okay? So just give me a moment. I'll just share you that link again. I think the link is with you for the yesterday, but I would request not to open that as of now. Please focus on the today's session, because see, you are going to learn artificial intelligence, and that what you are going to use in your project, which will make you win the wonderful AI robotic kits. So I want everyone to be focused here. Okay. So I'll just share my screen. So I hope my screen is visible to you all. Just give me a moment. Yeah, so I hope my screen is visible to you all. Can you please respond me on the chat that is it visible or not? Okay, yes, wonderful. Okay, so here, as started by Mr. Shalin, that we were talking about the Alexa, Right. So definitely we all know that this is a device which is using an artificial intelligence. But how exactly this device is using an artificial intelligence, we should know that. Because if we will be knowing about the existing objects which are using an artificial intelligence, then only we can develop our own things, right? So on the example, you can see the person over here is just asking something to the Alexa. Do I need an umbrella? And you can see the reply by the Alexa is no rain is expected in San Francisco today. So you can notice one thing. First thing which we should notice here is the way, the language in which the user have asked the question, he has got his reply on the exact same language. Like he used the English language, he got the reply in English language. Now, the second thing you might be thinking that why exactly Alexa replied about the rain? If I talk about the usage of umbrella, definitely umbrella can be used for high sunlight as well. So let me tell you a little working behind it. As soon as the human, or I should say the user, asked the Alexa, do I need an umbrella? The first thing what Alexa did was it just searched a database and found out the result why exactly umbrella is used. After finding the result for that, there might be some of the options. First, you can see like on high sunlight, on high rain, right? So there are some different specific situations where umbrella is used. But along with this, Alexa also detected the location of that person. And after detection of location, it was very clear to Alexa that the user is asking for the umbrella for the rain purpose. And this is why you can see two things on the reply of Alexa, that first is no rain is expected, and even it replied with the place where exactly the user was situated. So now you can think how the AI has gone so big, right? So the machines have grown up so big that they are able to detect your locations, they are able to understand what you are trying to say. And all this is possible just due to the artificial intelligence. Now let's see some more examples. So if I'll show you this example, this is an example of face filter. And here you can see on the face filter, I think this might be very, very, this application might be very, very, in use with all of you, right? You might be using these application. So let me tell you, you might be using this application for so long, but do you know that this application also uses an artificial intelligence? And the answer is yes. And let me tell you how. So you can see the filters which has came up on the face of the person in front of the camera is just exactly located at the perfect place. And even with the movement of face, those filters are not getting away. Why? Because as soon as the person came upon the camera, it just detected the different face points and located the forehead, located the ears, located the nose, okay, using an artificial intelligence and brought up the filter. And it is working on a real time. You can see even with the movement of the face, the filters are not getting away. Now, let me give you this wonderful example. And I should tell you that this is one of my favorite examples for artificial intelligence. So here you can see, this is a picture, something of a self-driving car. On the first time, you might think that what exactly is happening in the picture, but just try to understand what I'm explaining you. Just think a situation that you are sitting on a self-driving car, and self-driving car is a car, it drives it by its own. No person or no human drives it, okay? So you can see it is, the car is bringing up so many boxes around the different objects and also detecting those objects. So you can see it is detecting bus, person, motorbike, person, motorbike, car, different person. Also along with this, you can see here, just give me a moment. I'm sorry. Yeah. So you can see here that it's not only detecting the different objects, but it is also measuring the distance, right? So you can see when a car moved towards the zebra crossing, and here you can see there was a small kid in a, you can say a bike yeah, you can say a bike. On the bike, it was a small kid, and car just stopped before it. When it got to know that the distance between the person and the car, that it itself has become very less. So this is we called as an AI student. So here is, you can see the things are taking the decisions by their own, right? So let me give you some more good example, and this is an industrial application. So here you can see on a tray, there are so many pancakes, right? But the machine is just picking up only the pancakes which have been baked. So try to understand one thing. There are so many pancakes, but there is someone who is taking a decision behind this, that what pancakes have been baked. And the thing which is behind this is artificial intelligence. To show you this, you can understand this picture of in a mall or some a big place, like a public place, and AI is used in surveillances. And surveillances, you can understand as in security. So here, on the by the just a single camera, it is detecting the different things which a man is carrying or a person is carrying. Right, so you can see it is detecting that the person is carrying a bag, a person is having a dress, a person is having, and also the whether the person is adult, whether the person is male or female. But how can this be useful for humans? So students, just think, if I give you a scenario, till the time what exactly has to happen, that there was some incident, and after that the cops used to come there and investigate the things and used to catch that thief, or I should say the convicted person. But using an artificial intelligence, it is just leveling up the human so much that they are able to detect the things beforehand. And now here you can see they are, if someone comes with any weapon or a wrong intention, it will be detected by the camera, and before that person can harm to the public, the person can be caught. So you can see here that how artificial intelligence is helping us, right? Now I'll just stop the screen share and let me ask you some questions. That so now are you interested for artificial intelligence? Do you feel artificial intelligence is helping us? Can I have your responses on the chat? After seeing so many examples, do you think artificial intelligence is helping us? Okay, so Vabhavi has answered yes, wonderful, wonderful. I can just say yes, amazing. So this is the reason, students, we want you to first understand the use case, because this will give you a vision and this will give you an idea how you can use an artificial intelligence to simplify your problem using and just making a good projects in the PictoBlocks, right? So let me now just ask you a one question, and I would love to get the answers on the chat box. So the question here is, I'm sorry. So how do you feel when you get all your questions correct in a tough exam? Can you please answer me this question, that how do you feel when you correct all the questions in a tough exam? Okay, so I can see some of the answers, happy, proud. Or if I ask you one question, that how do you feel if you solve a challenging puzzle in a record time? Okay, self-confident, I can see so many good answers. Okay, confident, happy, nice, proud, wonderful. So yeah, of course, these are the feelings what we feel. But let me take you to one more feeling that everyone have, but we don't recognize it, right? So the feeling is, I'm so intelligent. So do you feel this? Like if you correct all your questions, so do you feel, yeah, I'm so intelligent, I corrected all the questions, and I have also solved the puzzle in a record time. Brilliant. I just got one answer by Pihu. Brilliant. Yeah. So this was what I was talking about. Yeah, intelligent. So we also feel very intelligent. But the if we want to understand what is artificial intelligence, we should also understand what human intelligence is. Because if we will be understanding what human intelligence is, it will become very easy for us to understand an artificial intelligence. Yes, I can see so many good answers. Yes, I feel proud, brilliant, of course. So now, students, let's understand what exactly is human intelligence, or I should say intelligence. So basically, students, there are three steps here. You can understand it as the ability to perceive, understand, and analyze the information, the ability to learn and increase the knowledge, and ability to make a decision based on the knowledge. Yes. So what are these three steps? Yeah, so this makes you an intelligent. So let me give you a short example to explain this part. So just remember a first time when you might have encountered a fire, whether it can be on TV, it can be on real, it can be on screen, anywhere. So what was your first thing? What was your first understanding? So you thought that this fire is very attractive. Wow, the feeling we feel as in, wow, what is this? It is so amazing when we see fire for the first thing. But what happened the next? When we go very near to it, we started getting a burning sensation on our face and the body, right? And there we analyze the information that the fire is not always good, but this can put you in danger sometime, right? Similarly, you got when you encountered this, you analyzed an information and kept this information in your mind, right? And what happened? You came back to the home and you just saw your parents cooking the food on the stove. And what exactly you saw there? Oh, stove is also working with a fire. But definitely the parents are cooking the food with a distance, a precautious distance to make the food. And also the fire, the size of the fire is very small. So here you learned and increased the knowledge about the fire that it can be in the different forms and it is not always dangerous, but it can be also very useful. Let me give you add one more step to this example that you were just roaming around your home and you just found a matchstick. And you just saw, oh, this is also a source of fire, right? And you understood, but this is a very small source of fire, but it can be very dangerous. So it has to be always used under the supervision of parents. And now just understand the situation came, I should say not the situation, but a wonderful day came of your birthday. And I just brought a wonderful cake in front of you. And there was a candle. And I asked you, please, can you just lit this candle? So what exactly was your step? So my question is, like, if I brought a cake in front of you on your birthday and there is a candle on it, and if I asked you to just lit this candle, so what you are going to do? Are you going to take that candle to the big fire outside? No, right? Are you going to take that candle to the stove? Again, a big, you will be using a matchbox, okay, under the supervision of your parents to lit that candle. And here, this is what makes you a very intelligent, that you can make a decision based on your knowledge after seeing different processes, different sizes, different use cases of fire to make the perfect decision for you, right? And as I said, this makes you intelligent, or you can say this makes human intelligent. Yes, I can see the answers, matchbox, wonderful, lighter, wonderful. So this was, I was expecting from you all. Yeah, exactly. Because I know you are intelligent and you will take the perfect decision. Now let's understand about the artificial intelligence. So what exactly it is? So students, till now you might have understood one thing, that we are telling an intelligence to a scenario where someone is taking a decision by their own, right? So if I talk about human intelligence, so humans are taking the decision by their own based on the knowledge which they have acquired. If I talk about artificial intelligence, students, computers and different machines are going to take the decision by their own as like an human intelligence. And this makes the artificial intelligence. That if a computer is able to take the decision, of course, there will be a requirement of a human intelligence, but the decision will be based totally upon the calculations made by the computer, we called it as an artificial intelligence. If you want to see a small definition, you can see a computer which can mimic a human intelligence or artificial intelligence. Here on example, you can see recognizing face, identifying the objects, reading and listening. So recognizing the face, I think now you might be able to relate the examples, right? So recognizing face is an example of a face filter. Identifying object, you can see, is an example for a self-driving car. Reading and listening can be good example for the Alexa, right? So I think this might be very clear for all of you that what exactly is artificial intelligence. Let me tell you to the different techniques of artificial intelligence, but again, I would like to stop my share here for a moment and let me take your responses. So till now, is everything clear? Can we get your response on the chat, students? Okay, wonderful. I can see by Anchal, yes, it's clear. Yes, yes, yes. Prerna has mentioned yes. Okay, Pradnya has also mentioned understood. Wonderful. Of course, you have to share your project, but not now. I will be sharing you the links. Okay. Now, I think Charlene sir has joined back with us.
Yes.
Yeah, Charlene, so I was taking the students through what exactly this artificial intelligence is. So let me just give you them much more idea and the different techniques which will be used. And then I think you can take them to complete the activity. Okay. Sure. So students, let me share back my screen. And before that, I would like to share some links so that you can be ready with this. So students who are using a PictoBlocks in their laptop and PCs, they can use this link. The students who are using the, who want to use the PictoBlocks in their Android phones, smartphones, so they can use the link below. And also we have a little surprise for all of you that you will be really love to hear that. So we have also launched our PictoBlocks on web versions. So students, if you guys are finding a problem to download and do the things, you can now do all the activities on the web version. So I will be sharing you that link also. Okay, so let me just share you this link. So you can also come and do your activities on the web version. So you can open up on this, open this link on the Chrome, and you will be able to see the PictoBlocks. So let me just give you a little glimpse of it, how exactly it looked like. So yeah, students, so this is our PictoBlock.ai web version. So here you can see the PictoBlocks is running on the browser. So this is, this you can also use, okay? So yeah, taking back to you to the slides and give you, yeah, I'll share you the link also, don't worry, I'll share it to you again, okay? So let me take you back to the different techniques. What are the different techniques? So here you can see there are different techniques like face recognition, computer vision, text recognition, speech recognition, machine learning, and pose detection, right? So what are these techniques? So students, these are artificial intelligence techniques. So as of now, you know artificial intelligence is a globe, okay? And you can understand these are the small nations in it, okay? So here, all these activities are very much possible on PictoBlocks, and we are going to teach you some of the good activities among these examples. So let me just give you a little understanding about it. So face recognition, so you can see here, you can in PictoBlocks, you can do this activity and you can recognize the gender, the age of the person in the camera. You can use the computer vision technique and you can detect different celebrities, different logos, and the different objects on the picture. Using text recognition, you can bring up any picture or anything written on the paper or somewhere in front of the camera, and your PictoBlocks will be able to detect those things. If I talk about speech recognition, so you can also make some projects like in Alexa where you will be, your voice will be recognized by the PictoBlocks, and you will be able to give the instruction using your speech. We will be talking about machine learning in coming webinar, but to give you a little understanding, machine learning is a technique under an artificial intelligence where we make our machine learn different concepts and make get our desired output. You can also use a post detection method of post detection technique of artificial intelligence where you can detect the pose of the person. But not only this, you can also detect the repetitions done by them. So now I will hand over the screen to Mr. Shalin, and he will be explaining you about the AI technique that is face detection. Okay, how exactly it works and how we can make these activities. And yeah, Shalin.
Yes. So I'm sharing my screen with you all. I hope my screen is visible to you all.
Yes, it's visible.
Yeah. So AI techniques of face detection, right? So it's a very wonderful technique. But what happens in this technique? Here, what we do, we are able to recognize the person's age, gender, emotion and position. But how? It will going to recognize your face, the face features, and based on that it will going to tell the gender of the person, the age of the person and the emotion of the person. Like you have seen this kind of a features in the smartphones also, like when you just open the camera and just trying to click your picture, it will going to make a square box around the face and show your age, right? So this is a very wonderful technique of an face detection. So, but how the face detection actually works, that is a tricky part. So let's understand that part. Here you can see the girl, right? You can see on the face border of the girl, the green dots are there. But what are that green dots? That are basically the 68 predefined features, the landmarks. Okay, so based on this landmark, we are able to recognize the important patterns, and based on that patterns we can able to recognize the person's emotions, age, gender, right? So what happens, like if some features are missed over here, if some feature missed, then based on the remaining features it is capable of giving you the decision. Right here you can see the girl is posing sometimes to the left, sometimes to the right side. So definitely some features were going to be missed. Based on the it has the capability. Okay. Yeah. This is going to place expression recognition. The going to recognize your face, right? Multiple. So let's do. So we are going to make these things on our web app, that is a pictoblocks.ai. yeah, so like those student is who are not able to download the pictoblocks, right? So what they can do, there is an application name as pictoblocks.ai, and based on that and there we can just find out how we can make a different things. Okay, are you sure? Is my voice is audible to you?
Yeah, now it's audible. I think there was a little crackling while explanation of a face, how exactly face detection work.
Okay, like if it is audible now, so I just explain them again about it.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
Please. So in the face expression, you have seen over there a multiple green dots are coming around the face. So what does that green dots are? That green dots are basically the landmarks. There are 68 predefined landmarks, and based on that landmarks, we are able to define out the patterns. What are the patterns? Like based on these patterns, we are able to find out the person's age, gender, emotion, right? So let's try. Now we are going to make an activity for finding out the emotion, right? Face expression. So I'm going to make an activity in front of you now. So we are going to make this activity on pictoblocks.ai. Yes. So you have given that the link in the chat also. So if anyone is facing a problem in downloading sometimes, so what you can do with the help of the web version, you can perform the things over there. So I'm sharing my screen of the web app. Yeah. So is my PictoBlocks screen is visible to all?
Yeah, yeah, it is.
Okay, that's great. So yeah, so first of all, in this part, what we will do, as it is an artificial intelligence part, so what we are going to do, first of all, we are going to add the extension of an artificial intelligence. So we need to go on add extensions. There is an artificial intelligence block, so we are going to click on it, and the artificial intelligence related all the blocks are coming over here. Okay, so as we are recognizing the face, so we don't require the 2B, we will require a square box. Okay, so I'm going to choose a sprite as a square box like this, and I'm going to delete the 2B. Okay, yeah. So first of all, from the event block, we are going to choose the when flag clicked. Okay, we are going to choose the when flag click. You all know what happens with the when flag click. Whenever we click on the green flag, whatever the blocks are given written below the when flag clicked will going to start executing. So after the when flag clicked, we are going to use an initial level. We will going to use the hide block. Okay, we are going to use the hide block. Now, what is this hide block about? Basically, see, when I just click on this block, so my square box is getting hide. So at an initial level, I don't want my square box to be visible. So that's why I'm applying the hide block. After the hide block, I'm going to use turn on a video on a stage with 0% transparency. So what this block will do? This block will going to turn on my video on the stage area. Like, see, if I put it on, so you can see my video on the stage area. Here we have the three option: off, on, and on flip. If you put it as off, then my video will be not visible. If I put it as on flipped, then you can see my mirror image, right? Yes. And if you just put it as a 0% transparency, so it is completely visible. If you put it as 100%, then it will not be visible, right? So I'm going to put it as a zero only and put it over here. Okay, so after that, what I need to do, I will going to recognize the features, right? Recognize the image features. So with the help of which extension we can do? So here we are having recognize face details in an image after a 2 seconds. So from here we can recognize the face details. Okay, so with the help of this face details, we can able to find out our face and important features. Okay, yeah. So yeah, so now what we are going to do, as it will going to recognize our face features from there, then after that, what we are going to do, we are going to create a variable. Why we are creating a variable? Because we need to also count how many faces are there in an image. So I'm going to create one variable as a face first of all. So creating a variable as a face. So set face to 0. Okay, so we are setting our face variable to 0. Once we set it to 0, then what we are going to do, we are going to use repeat until now. We're going to use repeat until. What happens with the repeat until? It will going to repeat the same steps for the multiple of a time, for the multiple images. Yeah, so like the things will going to be repeat continuously until the given conditions, whatever the conditions we give here, proves right. Okay, so what we are going to do, I give here things like this equals to, if my face recognition count, right? So if my face recognition count is equals to my variable face, okay, is equals to my variable face like this, right? And after that, what we are going to do, we are basically changing our variable by one, okay? But before changing our variable by one, I think so we need to find out the important positions over there, like important face first of all, the emotions of the face, right? So how will we are going to do that? We are going to use create a clone of a myself, right? See, create a clone of myself. So this basically create a copy, okay? This basically creates a copy, okay? So yeah, sorry, this basically creates a copy of your face. So exactly here we are using the square box, no? So basically the square box copy will going to be available over there, but where here I will write when I start as a clone. So what will happen in this part? Basically here we are going to mix the square box around the face. So how we just make the square box? So for that, suppose for an example, if we are having the face, so there is a height and a width of the face, right? So with that width and with that height and X and Y position, we are going to mix the box. How? Let's learn. So first of all, we are setting its size. So from the looks block, we are having the set size 2. Okay, and in this set size 200, we need to give the width. So from where we can find out the width? So yeah, here recognize X position in place, we are going to put a width of a face 1. So what we are going to do, we are going to put our variable face over here like this, okay? So we are going to put our variable face here. Then after that, what we need to do, we need to put the X position and Y position. So for that, we will go to the motion block and we are having set X2, set Y2. In this part, we are going to put recognize X position and recognize Y position. Of what? Of our variable face. Yeah, like this. Okay, now what we want, we will going to say our face expression. So I'm going to apply the say block here, right? And once we apply the say block, then what we are going to do, just apply recognize emotion of our variable face, right? And as it is a height, now we are applying the show block. Okay, so first of all, let's run it, let's see what happens actually. So it is not showing anything, so we need to find out some bugs. There might be some error or bugs, right? So I think so I need to apply the show block here like this. Yeah, so let's try to find out now. Yeah. Okay. Okay, fine. I think there is some issue. Okay, fine. So what we can do, no, just apply a quick change, like that I think there is some problem in my system that this AIA function is not working. So what we can do, just we can do the same thing with a different extension also. So let's do that. What we can do, just with a face detection extension is also there. So in the face detection extension, it can also recognize the emotion, like expression. Okay, so what I can do, I can add it, a very few changes will be required, else the things will be perfect one over here. Just a hold for a second, as the extension get loads, it requires some times to open.
Okay, students, I can see some of the students are finding problem to understand what exactly is going on, which extension is used. So students, don't worry. Okay, so we are going to explain you this part again, a complete setup, how you can do this. Okay, so right now the model is getting loaded. Okay, so just let it be completed. So first of all, I would like to draw your attention towards one thing. So Shaleen, just please, can you show up the different extensions in the PictoBlocks?
Yeah. Like
so this. Here, students, you can see. So now I think the voice will be clear. So on the first, this is the face detection extension, which we are going to use it. Okay. And we are going to tell you from very beginning. Okay. I can see there was some voice cracking as per some students. Some things were not visible. Okay. So students, if you're finding any network issue, just please click on the reconnect option in front of you. And yeah, Shaleen, I will just request you to like just start from the beginning, so that because there was some network issues for some students, so they were not able to see which blocks you were using. Okay, so you can tell them from initial. Yeah.
Okay. So see, like we have artificial intelligence extensions, we can perform all these things related to the face, emotion, age, gender. Okay, but we have a special extension also as face detection. Okay, so like what I will do, I start from the beginning so that you will go and all things. Okay, that will I think the same thing. So let's find out the things first of all. So
yeah, hello. I think now you can hear me. So students, can you hear me now? Just please answer this on the chat. Can you hear me now? Yeah. Can you hear us now? Yes, wonderful. So not a problem. See, I'll try to like explain you all this completely thing. So due to some network issue, because you know, in some parts of the India there is a cyclonic wave going, so there might be some issues with it. Not a problem. Okay, so now I'm going to share my screen and let me explain you the part which he was trying to explain you. So hope my voice is clear to we'll share you this, don't worry, we'll share you the links and everything. So now I think my PictoBlocks screen is very visible to you all, right? So I'm going to explain you what's very beginning. Just give me a moment. Let me just bring the things required for this extension and explain you the part. So the first important part which you have to take care is, students, that you have to be signed into the PictoBlocks. Okay, which is the most important thing, that if you want to use an artificial intelligence or machine learning extension, so the most important thing is you have to be signed into the PictoBlock. So let me just show you how you can sign in. So through this, you can sign into the PictoBlock. Here you have to click on register. If you click on register, you will something like this. You have to click a student. You have to just select what is your age. Once done, you have to fill the required details and click on create my account. Once this part will be completed, you will receive an email on. So yeah, this is the latest version. Actually, this is the pictoblocks.ai. So you can see, so I'm working on the browser. Okay, so you can see I'm currently working on the browser. Okay, so now you can see that this is a pictoblocks.ai, right? Now, after once you receive a, I should say, email from the PictoBlocks, you have to click on I activate that. And after that, you can work with different wonderful extensions of the PictoBlocks. Show you that how we can make, okay, still if the students are finding a problem on hearing me, just request you to please click on the reconnect option. Okay, so Yashasvi, I got your point that let me ask with other students, am I audible students? So students, can you reply that am I audible now to you all? Yes, okay. Can I have a reply of other students? Okay, yes, yes, yes. So Yashasvi, if you are finding a problem with my voice, you can please click on the connect option. So let me tell you how you can add extensions. Click on the add extension option on the bottom left corner, and you will see face detection. You have to click face detection, and you will see the blocks over here. Now to start with refresh, just for everything, from the first thing what is required, if I want extension to be detected, okay, I'm gonna bring this video on stage. Okay, so let me just up here and so let's just let it back. So now you can see me. But my face is visible on the camera of the day. My face is visible on the page. Okay. Now, after the students, you have to do this. See, once I have the camera, then I am available on the stage. Right. So now what you can do here is you have to analyze. Right. As you already know, in artificial intelligence, it's important to analyze the things. Right. So we are analyzing. First, let me explain to the blocks which are going to do. Okay. And what we are going to. Okay. I can see some people are from. Problem with the voice. Okay. Just give me more strength, then do it. Yeah, hello students, am I audible to you now? Can you hear me now? Yeah, I just checked. There might be some network issues or something. So can you hear me now? Yes, okay. And now I can see, now you can hear me, yeah? Okay, wonderful, wonderful. Not a problem. See, in the online education, there are certain times that we face a network issue, okay? Okay, wonderful. Now let me just share my screen back and explain you the part. Okay, wonderful, student, thanks. So basically I was here, okay, I was explaining you the different blocks required, okay? So now here you can see, we just first use the block, which is turn on the video on the stage with 0% transparency. So this is something which is going to bring me up on the stage. I'm going to first explain you the different blocks and then gonna make the script so that the concept behind it should be very clear. After this, there is a block which is going to analyze the image from the camera or the stage. So this is going to take your face details. And let me, one question was asked that whether the camera is going to take the, whether the camera is going to, the face details. So here, analyzing image, it means analyzing the different face points of your face. It's not your scanning your face, okay? So it is going to detect the different face points, okay? So if I'm going to click it, it is going to first analyze. So you can see my video is little stuck because it just took some screenshot and it is just analyzing it. Yeah, sure, sure, Prerna. I'm just trying to explain this part from very basic and very start again. Now you can see when it has analyzed that there is a some person on stage, it brought some bounding box automatically, right? Okay, so now let me show you some more blocks in it. So it's a get the number of faces. So from here you can see how many number of faces have been detected. Also, if I want to check the expression, we can use get the expression of the face. Okay, if my code is not visible, let me like zoom it. Is it visible to you all now? Can you see it now? Can you please reply me on the chat? So is the codes visible now? So can you see the codes now? I have little zoomed in. Okay, I can see now, yes, from the audience, okay. Okay, still some people are finding some problem. Okay, okay. So see, you can check what I'm trying to see. You can hear to me, okay, because you wanna see different blocks over here. Okay, so I'm taking up the block and bringing it on the scripting area. Okay, now I think the students are replying with yes. So now students, we are going to use different, blocks here to make a face recognition, which is going to recognize our face expression. And how that can be done is, so we have turned on the video on the stage. Now you can see me on the stage, right? The next step is we are going to bring a block. Let's take repeat. So why I'm repeating it? Because I don't want to waste the execution power, okay? I don't want it should be working again and again, and I just want it should just check the things. Okay, so I have just kept 5 times repeat. Okay, now I have added analyze image from the stage. So it is going to analyze 5 times, right? After that, students, there is a palette called as operator. And here you can see we have a different blocks, which is like greater than, less than, equal to, and different ones. And how this can be used is, I'll go to control, and let me bring this block which says if then else. And what this block is used for, so this block is used if the above condition is true, the white space just behind the if hand is going to be executed. And if the above statement is false, the white space blocks present just below the else are going to work. So how can I take use of it? So I'll go to operator. Okay, I'll bring this symbol that is greater than, and I'm going to compare it. So now you can see the number of faces is 1, and I'm checking it to 50. So what it should come? It should come false, right? So what I'm going to put it here is 0. So this means every time if the my pictoblox detects that there is a person, I want to get the expression of that person. So I added this if here, and I'll put this inside here. Okay, when this condition is going to be false, right now it is giving true because currently I'm on the stage, but when this condition is going to be false, that there will be no person on the camera, what I want is my Toby should say no person detected. Okay, no person was detected. I put it in the else part. But what I want if there is a person? Okay, so now what if there are person on the camera? So what I want here is I'll go to face detection. I'll bring show bounding box. I want where exactly the person is, there should come a bounding box. Also, I want that my Toby should say the emotion. So I'm bringing the say block, and this was, so right now you can see it is showing neutral. So I'll add it here. So now my Toby is going to say neutral, and I'll put it here. And you already know, let me like little zoom out. So now you already know that we, to start the script, we generally use when green flag is clicked, so that we can actively work very easily. So let me now click on the green flag and show you how exactly it is working. So now you can see it is detecting. Right, and let me just show you this on the full screen. So now just see this. So different expressions can be detected using this way, students. You can detect expressions like sad, you can detect expressions like fear, anger, okay, happy and surprise. I have already shown you. So this is something how you can make a face expression detected. Okay, so yeah, I'll just stop my share here and let me come to you on the, yeah. So hope you have understood the things, right? And let me now, some students were asking for the details of the competition. So let me just share my screen back and tell you the details of the competition. So here, students, you can see, as you already know, on this Scratch week with PictoBlox, we are teaching you the PictoBlox from very scratch, and also you are eligible to be part of the competition. We will be sharing you the link now. Okay, what are the major things you require is you have to attend all the 3-day session, and you have to submit your video of your project. Okay, basically you have to submit the link of your video. Okay, you have to upload the video to the YouTube and share the link in the form. Okay, and this will make you eligible for the certificates, as well as you can win a wonderful AI robotics kit that is Corki. So I'll again stop my share and come back to you all. Right. Yeah, you have to use a PictoBlox for this. Okay, this is a compulsory that you have to use the PictoBlox. So let me just share you the link where you can submit your YouTube video link. Please go through this form link. Okay, so this is a form link, submission form for submitting your project video. Okay, here you have to submit your videos, and the last date of submission of this is 23rd. So what is the topic? So topic, you can choose it by your own, but you can keep it on automation, you can keep it on COVID, you can keep it on anything you like, but yeah, definitely So what is the topic for the competition? Topic is artificial intelligence and machine learning. Now it's up to you that how you come up with your creation and innovation solving the real world problems. Okay. So about for the rest of today's webinar video, let me just share. So if you have missed yesterday's session, not a problem. I'm just sharing it to you for your revision. Okay, you can take it. And let me just share the link of this. Although you will be receiving an email from us where we are have mentioned about this. And also, as I mentioned, that we have launched, we are about to launch our Quirky. So if you want to sign up for the Quirky for an early discount, so we have already, we will be sharing you the link in the email you will be receiving with us. Okay. So hope you have enjoyed the session. You have learned the things and okay. So how we are going to find the winner. So yeah, so you're picked by our jury and they will give you the points on your video or project thinking, like how, what is the idea behind the project and how you have made the video, what are the content on it and how your project is working. Okay, so you want me to share the link again. So let me just paste it again. So this is a submission form link. As I told, you will be receiving a short, an email from us shortly, where you will be receiving this form link, also an early bird discount link, where you can register yourself for the early bird discount for the Quirky. So thank you all for joining and hope you have enjoyed the session. We are looking forward from you wonderful projects and your enjoy towards the Scratch Week. Thank you for joining. We will be meeting you back tomorrow again. Thank you.